Hi everyone, I'm Ricky from Tech Talk, and today I want to go through all the accessibility settings that we're going to find on the Vodafone Smart N9. This is one of my most favourite videos I like to make on the channel, highlighting all the different features on here, making it possible for people with a disability to use these great smartphones. So for this, what we need to do is jump into our settings. So slide up, scroll through, jump into the settings icon, which is the gear icon here. Scroll all the way through the list until you hit the bottom. Count four from bottom, 1, 2, 3, and 4. You have little man stood out here with his arms out and his legs out. This is your accessibility option. So inside accessibility, we've got help tips. This will help you guide through your phone, give you helpful tips as well to point out new things on your device and get you through and using your device the best way possible. Underneath that, you have the volume key shortcuts. So we have the option here of using the volume keys, which are down the right hand side and are smooth compared to a textured power button, which is great to see as well. When this is toggled on, you have three options. You have your talk back option, select to speak, or switch access. We're going to choose talk back and we're going to hit OK. So now that's toggled on, let's go home. So pressing the volume keys, both of them at the same time, so the up and down.
Standard home screen.
Talk back is on and ready to use, which is a great feature there. So coming down into more in-depth settings now, we have select to speak. So once select to speak is toggled on and there's a menu to agree to, you'll notice we now have a fourth icon down here at the bottom. So your little accessibility man is down here at the bottom. Press play.
Navigate up, select to speak, on, settings. When select to speak is on, you can tap specific items on your screen to hear them read aloud.
So then it will go through and read everything that's on your display. You can then also stop, press again, then you can highlight something.
When select to speak is on,
and it will start again from there, so which is a great option, and I really do like using that. Another great option, which is underneath, is switch access. So this gives the people abilities to use switches to scroll through, click, and use their smartphone with a separate switch device, which is really good to see as well. Underneath that, we have another great feature that I like, is talk back. So talk back is very much like select to speak. The difference from talk back is that it will always talk to you wherever you go to on your device. So you can touch and highlight certain areas.
When talk back is on, your device provides spoken feedback to help visually impaired users.
You can then use that to go through the toolbar up here at the top and find out information.
Selected, Vodafone UK, out of list, Wi-Fi 3 bars, 1533, 4G phone 2 bars.
So it will highlight everything that's in your taskbar there for you, which is great. So say we want to go back into our menu, double tap.
Accessibility.
And then use two fingers.
Showing items 1 to 10 of 20.
So TalkBack is a great feature there that will highlight and talk back everything to you on your device, and this will work throughout the device, which is a great feature I love to see on all Android smartphones. Underneath that, you have the text-to-speech output here, so you can change your pitch and your tone of the voice feedback that you'll have from TalkBack or the select-to-speak options that we have tested already. Carrying on down, we're going to talk about the display. So underneath here, we have font size, and as you can see, I've got it set to the largest. Underneath that, you then have display size. So inside display size, you do have a couple of windows that you can see the difference. Underneath that, we have magnification. So inside magnification, you can do this with a single tap. So inside here, you have two options. You can magnify with triple tap or magnify with button. So first of all, magnify with triple tap is relatively easy. 1, 2, 3. Three quick taps with one finger will zoom in your display. You can then use two fingers to pinch in and zoom, and then you can move around your display, making it ever so easy to fly around. 1, 2, 3 will bring you back. There is also another option. 1, 2, and then on the third is hold. So you press three times, but hold on that third time. Then you can scroll around your display here, release, and it will zoom back out for you. Then going into magnification with buttons, so we're gonna go in here, toggle this on. You'll see our little accessibility man pop back up again. Tap this, and then tap anywhere on the display, and it's gonna zoom straight in for you. With two fingers, you can then move around your display. You can also pinch to zoom as well. Then you tap your accessibility man. This will take you back to your default size. Underneath that, you have color correction. You have color inversion. Also, this will put white text on a black background, but will totally change the colors throughout the device, so please be aware of that. You have large mouse cursor, so you can use a mouse cursor with this if that helps as well. And underneath that, you can use click after mouse cursor stops moving. The power button on the right hand side here can end your calls. Auto screen rotate is already on and functioning very well. You've got touch and hold delay here for dexterity issues. If you have dexterity issues or like the shakes, you can have touch and hold delay there, which will improve them. Moving into auto audio systems here. We have mono audio, you have captions, giving you the ability to use captions on your smartphone, which is a great option. Then finally at the bottom, you've got high contrast text. So if I toggle this on or off, you can see it becomes a little bit bolder. Then you have scheduled power on and off as well, finally at the bottom there. So going back home, I'm really impressed with the sheer amount of settings on here. And it's great to see that Vodafone has included this as well, because it is down to the manufacturers that choose the accessibility settings to be on there, as some don't. I'm really impressed to see them all on there. From a person that is visually impaired, it's great to see the talk back, the magnification, select to speak options. It's nice to see that they have covered a wide array of different disabilities, making it possible for everyone to use these great smartphones. If you have any questions or queries about the accessibility video or any other videos I've done on the Vodafone Smart N9, please drop a comment down below. I'd be more than happy to help. Please give the video a thumbs up, as it does help. And remember to subscribe to stay up to date with all our latest videos. From me, Ricky, I'll see you very soon. Bye for now.